Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. NASA's fiscal year 2015 budget proposal was announced March 4th. The $17.5 billion budget supports NASA's new strategic plan to drive advances in science, technology, aeronautics, and space exploration.
The president's funding plan for America's space program reaffirms the path we're on and will keep us moving forward, pushing farther into the solar system and leading the world in a new era of exploration.
The budget enables NASA to continue fostering growth of a vibrant American commercial space industry, stay on target to launch American astronauts from U.S. soil by 2017, keep utilizing the International Space Station until at least 2024, and carry out even more ambitious missions beyond low Earth orbit.
This budget keeps us on the same steady path we've been following, a stepping stone approach to send humans to Mars in the 2030s. It's a path that has seen many recent successes, from the launch of the Global Precipitation Measurement Mission last week, the first of an unprecedented 5 Earth science launches this year, to returning space station resupply missions to U.S. soil with private American companies, to the power-up of Orion and the countdown toward its first flight test later this year, to the final mirrors for the James Webb Space Telescope being delivered.
2 days after the budget announcement, NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden was the guest speaker at a luncheon on Capitol Hill sponsored by the Space Transportation Association. Bolden discussed NASA's budget, programs, and prospects for 2014 and beyond. The Space Transportation Association supports policies that advance robust, affordable space transportation for NASA, the Department of Defense, and the commercial market. The next crew of the International Space Station is training in Star City, Russia for its upcoming launch to the orbiting lab. NASA's Steve Swanson, along with Russian cosmonauts Alexander Skvortsov and Oleg Artemyev, are scheduled for a March 26 launch Kazakhstan time to begin a 6-month mission on the ISS as Expedition 3940. Meanwhile, NASA's Mike Hopkins returns to Earth March 11th while Rick Mastracchio remains on board as part of Expedition 39. Two of the 3 boosters that will power the Delta IV rocket scheduled to launch the Orion spacecraft on its first flight test this fall arrived by barge at Port Canaveral, Florida. The core and the starboard boosters were transported to Cape Canaveral Air Force Station for processing. The port booster is expected to arrive in April. Data from Exploration Flight Test 1 will assist in Orion's design and reduce overall mission risks and costs for later Orion flights. Administrator Bolden delivered the initial keynote speech at this year's Robert H. Goddard Memorial Symposium in Greenbelt, Maryland. The event attracts science and engineering leaders from around the world to discuss some of the most important issues affecting space exploration. This year's theme, Science and Exploration, Engineering the Future, celebrated past accomplishments while highlighting future space exploration priorities. March 6th marked the 5-year anniversary of the launch of NASA's Kepler spacecraft. The agency's first planet-hunting spacecraft launched from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station on a planned 3.5-year mission seeking signs of other Earth-like planets. Even though it completed its prime mission in November 2012, Kepler's data is still being used. To date, more than 3,600 planet candidates and 961 confirmed planets have been discovered. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.